Did you know that about 200 kids are currently being held by the Australian government in immigration detention centres? Some are held in Australia, others on an island a long way from here called Nauru. But lately, there's been growing concern for their welfare. A group of doctors from the Royal Children's Hospital in Victoria recently announced that they're now refusing to return kids sent to them for treatment from an immigration detention centre. But why? Here's Carl.
These guys are writing letters to their pen pals.
I like to cook, and when I'm older I want to be an actor in movies.
My favourite singer is Drake, and my least favourite singer is Taylor Swift.
The drawing below is a character from my favourite TV show, Adventure Time.
But these kids at a primary school in Melbourne haven't actually met their pen pals. They don't even know their names.
Hi, BTN. I'm Sarah.
And I'm Michaela.
We've been writing letters
to children in Nauru.
A particular image of the world.
These guys have been learning about refugees and asylum seekers in class. And they heard that some of the asylum seeker kids being held on Nauru, a tiny island in the Pacific, weren't very happy. So they joined a new program trying to help.
Lots of schools all around Australia create letters, and then the Befriend a Child in Detention program mails them off with a book to the Nauru Detention Centre.
That's one of the places where the Australian government sends asylum seekers who have tried to come to Australia. More than 600 asylum seekers are currently being held on Nauru, and that includes about 90 kids. The government says it's safe for them to be there, but many aid organisations disagree. And back in Australia, there have been some big protests from people like these doctors, who are worried about the physical and mental health of the kids kept inside detention centres.
Children from detention develop anxiety and depression. It's become so common that it's almost normal in detention for children to have these symptoms.
And communication with the outside world can be pretty tricky. That's why getting a single letter can make such a big difference for them.
Hello, my name is Harper and I am 12 years old.
I love music. In my spare time, I'm always listening to my favourite singer, Ed Sheeran.
I think the program is kind of about giving the kids and adults a kind of a chance to experience what it's like to be in Australia. As we're writing about our life, they would probably feel remembered as well.
So far, the program has been pretty successful. And the books they send have also been really handy for the kids on Nauru.
Many of the children in the detention centre are learning English, and so it's good for them to practice their English with books.
Children love receiving our letters.
And some of them even wrote back.
So this is a painting that I got from Christina in Nauru. It says, Christina, thanks you. So yeah, it's really nice.
Hi, my name is Heba and I love to cook. My favourite sport is tennis and soccer. Thank you for the book. I hope we meet each other.
They cried tears of joy when they figured out that there were letters inside of the book.
Some of the kids here have had lots of replies, and they hope that maybe they can even meet the kids on Nauru one day.
Dear Kithu, hi again. I'm just writing to give you an update and to say hello. Your reply was the best thing that ever happened to me. Thank you very much. My birthday's coming up. You are a really good pen pal.
I want them to know that they're not alone, and that there are people out there that care for them.
I hope you enjoy this letter and that you can reply. Lots of love, lots of smiles from Sunny.